Greetings and welcome to the first episode of the series known as Game Source. Game Source is a weekly series that discusses a wide variety of subjects found within the gaming industry. These episodes will be organized in four sections. The first section regarding Nintendo news, the second section dealing with Microsoft, the third section will be discussing Sony, and finally the fourth section will be dedicated to notable new trailers. Moving towards the first section dealing with Nintendo, we have much to discuss. However, first let's discuss a topic that I hold in great regard, Zelda Wii U. Take a gander at these articles. All sources used in this video is in the description below. Apparently, news outlets the world over are jumping to the conclusion on the possibility that Zelda Wii U may contain multiplayer elements. This assumption was made from one big sentence from Eiji Onuma. This is the quote. When I was talking back about making Zelda more than just a single-player experience, that's something you will see in the future, maybe next year. Note that if Zelda Wii U does contain multiplayer elements, these elements were not discussed. Personally, I'm not completely sure what to make of the quote. It could just be an off-the-wall assumption that fanned the flames of eager journalists, but keep the quote in mind for future reference. Regardless, Onuma has been very steadfast on his stance on a non-traditional Zelda title. Take a look at this article from Zelda Informer. In an interview discussing Hyrule Warriors, Onuma stated that he wanted the player to define their own experience within the gameplay. In addition, Onuma has compared the overworld of Zelda Wii U to Kyoto, Japan. Now take a look at some of these photos of the actual countryside in Kyoto. You can definitely see that some similarities between Kyoto and the overworld of Zelda Wii U. All in all, Zelda Wii U is shaping up to be a very unorthodox Zelda title. Moving on to Hyrule Warriors, we have a short update. New characters have been revealed in the new Zelda spin-off. Surprisingly, Agatha from Twilight Princess has been confirmed to be playable. In addition, the mystery blue-haired girl found in the first trailer has also been revealed. Her name is Lana, whom is a sorceress. She also has a connection with the sorceress Sia. In addition, Zelda in Hyrule has been confirmed to be Queen Zelda, which is a fresh change. Hyrule Warriors arrives in Europe on September 19th and North America on the 26th. Unfortunately, the special edition bundle that I have reported on previously has been noted to be a Japan exclusive. Now moving on to other Nintendo news, DLC has been confirmed for Mario Kart 8. A Mercedes-Benz add-on will be available to consumers sometime in July. Also, Bayonetta 2 is arriving in October with a remastered version of the first game, which looks quite promising. Also, costume skins of Nintendo characters will also appear within the game. Now let's move on to some really interesting news. Apparently, it is quite possible that Minecraft may be coming to the Wii U. In an interview with Shigeru Miyamoto, he has explained that a port may be very possible. Personally, I find Minecraft for the Wii U to be extremely likely. Moving on, we have some controversial news to discuss. Satoru Iwata has been re-elected as Nintendo's president. While it is true that Mr. Iwata has had his share of negative criticism, I believe a lot of it has been unwarranted. Mr. Iwata has had success with the original DS and Wii. I'm neither promoting nor criticizing his role as company president. This point is where I would talk about this article. Reggie Fils-Aimé has said that Nintendo will not abandon the Wii U, which is phenomenal news. Personally, I believe Nintendo will go into a prosperous curve in future Nintendo products. Now that's all I have to say in regards to section 1 dealing with Nintendo. Special thanks goes to PJC Link, Bruno Garcia, Chozo Diane Misery, and Ezekiel for contributing to this segment. Moving on towards the second section dealing with Microsoft, I go to David Is Cool.
Hey guys, what's up? It's Damon. First off, I want to say thanks to Andy. But before I talk about some of the games presented, know that some games are in fact multi-platform between Microsoft and Sony. With that being said, let's talk about a Microsoft exclusive known as Halo 5 Guardian. The game has been set to be released on the fall of 2015 for the Xbox One. Bonnie Ross, general manager of 343 Industries, has asserted the notion that Halo 5 will take full advantage of the Xbox One's full technological potential. In addition, by speculation, will follow the story of Master Chief, however will follow other characters such as the Mystery Spartan. In addition, other characters such as Arbiter will most likely be explored. Also, Halo 2 Anniversary has been revealed along with the Master Chief Collection. The Master Chief Collection will contain Halo Combat Evolved, Halo 2, 3, and of course 4 with all add-ons included. In addition, this version will contain a beta code for the Halo 5 Beta Access. The Master Chief Collection will be released on November 11th. Moving on to discuss GTA 5, Highest Will has not been released yet, or the release date at least. Let's talk about Bungie's new game Destiny. Achievements have finally been revealed, including trophies, so click here to check them out. In addition, Assassin's Creed Unity looks like it's taking its multiplayer mechanic very seriously. Taking place in the French Revolution, new iteration in the Assassin's Creed series does seem to have potential. In addition to have more non-linear game style, Unity promises to be a fresh new start for Assassin's Creed fans such as myself. That's all I got to say for section 2 regarding Microsoft news. Special thanks go to Mile2Frame9, Nancy King Cooper, and of course 77Ghost for contributing news to the segment. Moving on to our section 3 regarding Sony, we go to Everything I Can.
Thanks, Dave. The newly revealed Uncharted 4 Thieves' End has been speculated to be the last one in the series. It is a sad end, but I'm sure the game will go out with a bang. In addition, Alien Isolation has been noted to run at 1080p for both Xbox One and PS4. However, I am somewhat careful about Alien games since they have had mixed reviews in the past. Also, Sony has announced that they will have a greater emphasis on the PS Vita. The handheld is a source of criticism for lack of exclusive content. Maybe the Vita will have a turnaround. In addition, The Last of Us will receive a remastered version along with the bundle for the PS4. The remastered bundle version will arrive on July 30th. Now, that's all information I have to say for the third section regarding Sony. Special thanks goes to DragonDrake47 and SpiralFlyHigh420 for contributing to this segment. Back to you, Andy.
Thanks, Cam. Now, time to wrap up this episode with some notable trailers. A new Doom game was recently announced with a short teaser. I am a Doom fan, so I'm quite excited. Expect more information to surface at QuakeCon. Batman Arkham Knight has a new trailer with some new footage riding the Batmobile. Click here to watch it. Another anticipated game, Metal Gear Solid 5 The Phantom Pain, has received a new trailer, though some are calling the female sniper Quiet's character model to be over-sexualized. Let me know what you think about it in the comment section below. And finally, Mirror's Edge 2 gets some more concept art. I am a fan of parkour and freerunning, so I was ecstatic to see that Mirror's Edge got a sequel. Now, that's it for this week's episode. Episode 2 will be arriving on July 7th next Monday. Also, before I sign out, I want to give a shout out to Visual Uprising. Visual Uprising has made the new McIntyre Productions logo and channel banner. I honestly love the design and he is excellent to work with. I highly recommend him as an artist. I will leave his channel information in the description below. So this is the first episode of my new weekly series. I hope you enjoyed it. I also got some better equipment, so expect 1080p uploads to be a norm. You guys deserve the best. Also, if you have any information on any gaming topic, whether it be Nintendo, Microsoft, Sony, or PC news, comment below with a source and I'll feature your name on next week's episode. Please like, favorite, and subscribe if you're new. Till then, this is the video of the day.
Hold on, I just got out of the shower. There's some juice on the table.
Mm-hmm, take your time.
You want to explain to me what you're doing here?
I came looking for booty.
You came looking for sex with an underage boy?
Oh, no, I ain't come looking for no little bars. I ain't got no milk, no cookies, nothing. I came looking for man's butt.
A man's butt? Excuse me?
Oh, I know who you are, Chris Hansen. But see, I calls you Chris Hansen. I watch your TV show all the time. So you can go ahead and bring them cameras and them police is waiting outside. It don't make me no difference. Now, I tell you what. I like you, and I want you. Now, we can do this the easy way, or we can do it the hard way. The choice is yours.
Well, I don't think you and I will be doing anything any kind of way.
Okay, I see you choosing the hard way.
Okay, cut. This isn't working. Someone get this guy out.
Hey! Don't let me ruin that butt, no, Chris.
No, please.
I'm a warrior.
Somebody want